lot of the most interesting lyrics Beck has in the rap part, and he raps so well, sometimes it's hard to get all of it, but just looking at some of it, you know, where he sings, she rides in a car like a queen on a card, and the guns of her mind aim a line straight at mine. Again, like I had said with Asshole, I think that this woman is just really, I think maybe he's in the position where he's just not ready for this kind of love that she's sending him. And I feel like this gun imagery as well, we have that in, let's see. I feel like it's in a song when he says, we'll shoot our guns, we'll have fun. It might be Broken Drum, I'm not sure. But there's one.
That's exactly and right.
And then there's another one, I think it's on Sea Change. Maybe it's Lost Cause when he's like, shooting your guns at somebody new, you know? Like, so I think he feels like, you act like you love me now, but like, you know, you'll just fall in love with someone else. And I feel like he really does. He's like kind of afraid of what this, you know, actually it's interesting to see like, how is this going to unfold? Like, cause you know, there's this idea that when you create art, that, you know, kind of like that it can come true, like visualizing it, like the secret, all that kind of, all that ideology. Like, how is this going to unfold? You know, has he met this person yet? You know, I just feel like, you know, it's just this desire that he has, but he's afraid to act on it. But he's willing to do anything. I dragged all that I own down a dirt road to find you. Like, I'll give up everything, but he's still a little bit afraid. And that part of him, his mirror, his like unconscious self is missing, I guess.
I'd never looked at the rapping lyrics or the rapped lyrics of this song, to be totally honest. Like, I'm literally looking at the, like, she rides in a car like a queen on a card, and the guns of her mind aim a line. It's just really, you were just mentioning those, but yeah, I'm walking along with my boot full of rocks. I can't believe these tears were mine. I'll give them to you to put away in a box. Yeah, I mean, oof. He's had a lot of, I mean, like you say, we don't necessarily want to attribute this to a certain time or a certain person, but boy, the guy has suffered a lot in love, hasn't he? I mean, a lot of his love lyrics are very dark, and I think you're right. A lot of him is struggling. I don't know. Maybe I'm being a little too self-referential here, but I feel like a lot of his lyrics are about him struggling with love and maybe struggling not to lose himself and lose his sense of independence as an artist to love and to joining with someone. It feels like he finds fully joining with someone very scary.
And I think that too, but I think for her as well, you know, in some ways she's like telling him that she loves him, but he's kind of like, maybe you're not ready. Like, if we look at like that song Soldier Jane, for example.
Yeah,
like,
I love that
Soldier
song.
Jane, don't be afraid. Take your heart out of the shell. So she's kind of going through the same things too.
Oh yeah.
You know, like, she doesn't want to be injured either by because I mean, that's kind of like with love, and I think in Chemical as well, when we think about, again, Cruel Love Illusion, like, a lot of times, you know, love doesn't, you know, it's good in the beginning. How is it going to end up? Do I really want to make myself this vulnerable to someone? And I think as well, you know, she has flaws too. It's not just Beck, and it may be her even worse flaws, you know, worse things that she has, like addiction or just being scared. I mean, because obviously Beck, you know, he's not a drug user. He doesn't smoke. He doesn't, you know,
right.
But a lot of his vices, you know, they're not Beck. You know what I mean? Yeah. That he sings about. So it might be her as well dealing with stuff. So I think they're both scared, or this idealized image of this woman. But you know, I don't know. I just think it's a beautiful song. Sometimes, you know, it's his lyrics are just very striking. But then, you know, when you kind of take them in and like look at it again, it's like, wow, this really is beautiful. You know, that he's thinking about her so much that he's like, can you please, God, like, get her out of my head? You know, I feel like that's the first line. Yeah.
And it's amazing. But something you were saying about this remind me also, just actually, I'm almost reinterpreting now a little bit, Asshole, because the way you were just saying now, yes, Beck is afraid, but the girl is also afraid in a lot of these songs of his. And in that, you know, Call Her Name, She looks the same as you, question mark is stretched across her skin. She's also got a question mark. Like, she's also afraid. So I think you're right. A lot of these, he's portraying both himself and the possible partner as both being afraid. So that's really interesting. I love that.
Well, we can go to now, go Girl. To the next upbeat song, Night. Upbeat slash dark.
Yeah. Beck. I'm looking, I can see the first image here on the video is you can see downtown LA right there in the background. I'm sure if anyone from LA would probably know exactly where this video was filmed, but I'll play it and then we can talk about it a bit. And I know you know the video really well. I mean, this is probably one of his most well-known videos, I would say, in a way. Anyway, yeah, that's awesome. I loved hearing that. What do you got for us?
Oh, I love that you played it the whole way through. I was dancing while you were playing it in my seat.
Oh.
You know, it's interesting because there's a lot of, among his fans, there's a lot of debate on what is he saying. Because in the lyrics for the album, it doesn't say when he says girl, people are like, is it cyanide girl? Is it sunlight girl? Because in the lyrics, it just says dot, dot, dot. And he recently had like dot, dot, dot girl, like ellipses. And he recently had, it was like Ask Grammys Beck on Twitter. Someone again asked, what are you saying? And he's like, it's up for interpretation. But to me, I think he says sun-eyed girl. And the reason why I think that is we have on cell phones dead is we have the eye of the sun. And yeah. For me, I think, and this song, again, it's that it's a very obvious contrast between the light and the dark with this upbeat, positive or poppy, positive, kind of happy sound music. And then he has things called I'm going to steal her eye and I'm going to make her die. And then again in the video, there's a part in the video where he's walking down the sidewalk and there's a dead body, there's an outline of a dead body on the sidewalk. And he just walks through it, through the caution tape, like it's nothing, just like, so, and in some ways, I think Beck is like, you know, you might, you know, if you want to be with me, that's fine. But, you know, I'm not this like kind of sweet, you know, you know what, in some ways he is, but he's like, definitely like, I'm serious. Like, you know, maybe kind of like you, it's going to be a hard time being with me in certain ways. When I can't articulate how, but making someone die, you know, metaphorically is kind of like breaking down maybe some old barriers or deconstructing things or like a rebirth in order to be like worthy of him in a way, I would say. But I mean, I love this song. It's great. The video as well. He's paying homage to the Latino influence in his life when he was growing up. Also with Huero, which we talked about before, how he would be called that, I think it means like pale white boy. So he had to deal with that. So like I had spoke to you about it. I think that he's kind of reclaiming that kind of racism that he must have felt living there in his younger years. You know, just like I picture this little boy Beck going to school with his book bag, being called Cuero, hey Cuero, like everywhere he goes. And so I think that he, you know, he took that pain and like made this album. It's like one of his best albums, you know. So.
Right, totally. And that's really funny you point out the line, you know, I know I'm gonna steal her eye. She doesn't even know what's wrong. I know I'm gonna make her die. Take her where her soul belongs. Like that sounds like ego death. Like,
yes. It, you know. And also very like holy and spiritual in some way, but painful. But it's worth it. Like you're going to die. Like I'm going to go, you're going to go through, it's like kind of like a test, I think as well. Like when I think about, and just to be like, you know, not to go all religious, but just like God testing someone, like there's going to be a lot of pain you're going to go through, but in the end, you'll understand what was happening. But it's going to hurt. I'm just going to let you know off the bat, if you're going to get with me, it's going to hurt a little bit, but it's going to make you better. But I feel like as well, Steal Her Eye is a way for, with Beck as well, like he's very cryptic about, you know, he doesn't really share a lot about his private life. And he doesn't really share any interpretations of his lyrics really, or if he does, sometimes it's in it to mislead. But I think that this person is someone he can use her vision in some way to speak for him in a way, like a mouthpiece maybe, in some way, I guess. I don't know. But it's like basically I use your eye, like your eye is a lens that I see through and project. It's kind of like in a where it's at. I have two turntables and a microphone. You know, we can think about that him on the stage, but microphone can also be like my mouthpiece. So the things that I can't say, you know, you're the person that speaks for me because I kind of have to be this other, you know, I'm the celebrity, I'm this other person. I can't get involved in certain things or say certain things, but you can for me, you know, because of love, because you love me, so.
Right.